Hey guys, welcome to Lunatic Astrology. I'm your astrologer, Lori Lothian, and I just got off the beach today, a little sunburned, and I got the news of the Roe versus Wade declaration by the Supreme Court of the United States. I want to share the astrology of that momentous turnaround of a decades-old right for women to choose whether or not to have a child. It is a very shocking day for a lot of us, even though there was a lot of understanding this is likely what was going to happen. And the reason I want to share this with you, and I'll show you the sky, is that both the summer solstice ingress chart, when the sun went into Cancer December 21st in Washington, D.C., set for that location, and the sky today both suggest some kind of shock and awe, very disturbing content. The moon conjunct Uranus today, conjunct Pan, the asteroid Pan, which is in the house of courts, which is pandemonium, panic, etc. So the reason I want to do this is not to, like, hindsight is 2020, but to say, I'm going to say something like about reality now. I'm just going to just pass the astrology for a second, okay? Like, we're living in times in which polarization is so evident, and at the same time, reality is polarized. And what goes up always does come down. And so when the Roe versus Wade decision was created by the Supreme Court, I believe that was in the 60s, that was an extreme decision, taking the U.S. quite far to the left, or to the more liberal and, you know, that kind of culture. And, or maybe it was the 70s, sorry that I should know that. But anyway, and this is the other extreme. And so the only point I want to make before I show you the astrology is everything goes from one end to the other, and these days really quickly back and forth in reality. It's a part of the nature of reality. It is dual, it is polarized, it is hot, cold, up, down, in, out, yes, no, right? There we go, win, lose. So this is a heavy day for women. And so I am a woman, so I feel this heaviness as well. And I also don't want to get, you know, don't shoot the messenger here, please. I don't want anyone trashing me for talking about how I feel about abortion. I think that it is a woman's right to choose, but I also don't think like a third term abortion is a viable choice either. So I'm somewhere in the land of common sense. Alrighty. So this is the June 24th, 2022 natal sky, or the sky of Washington, D.C. And I chose 10:30 a.m. because as I looked through all the news stories today, I tried to track back roughly when this was announced. It seems like a Encyclopedia Britannica pegs it around 10:30 in the morning. Now, you can see that the moon is in Taurus. Now, that's true anytime today, like from like midnight last night through to the end of the day. So we do have a Taurus moon, and you can see that it is conjunct Uranus, shock and awe, in the house of courts, in the house of courts itself. And this is a chart set for DC today. So idea of legal affairs and courts, we have moon, Uranus, north node, inflaming, bringing it larger than life, Athena, rulings, logistics, strategy, knowledge and wisdom. Okay, all this intensity in that ninth house of courts and legal court cases. And shock and awe, yeah, this little moon is on an asteroid called Pan for pandemic, pandemonium, panic and fear. And of course, there is going to be a sense of panic. And already, I think five states, North Dakota or whatever, I don't remember who they are, guys, but I just read five states have outright just banned abortions, like end of story, not about the term, just end of abortion. So now we're going to have people flooding to other states or up to Canada, women who are desperate to not continue with a pregnancy. So anyway, the moon, of course, is representative of the feminine and women in the house of court. Shock. Here we have the shock. To add to that, Venus, who rules this ninth house at the time of this announcement or today, she's sitting here in Gemini, and she's what we call in astrology of the ancient world, in aversion to. So she cannot participate, bonify, sweeten up, or help the house where this is all happening. You have to understand how she's off duty. So where if she was here, she could have maybe mitigated it, maybe some kind of like ruling by the Supreme Court that has some kind of qualifiers to it, not just a, you know, blank carte blanche, abortion is not constitutional right. Okay, so end of that story. And this was, of course, coming for a long time as the U.S. Supreme Court was continually stacked with conservative judges. So this is also a long time coming, but nonetheless, the shock factor is here in the sky and cannot be ignored. Now, the next thing I want to go to in a minute is I'm going to go to the solstice chart, which shows a very interesting similar story that is happening that I think just portended that as well, except for Washington, D.C. Before I do that, let me also say this. United States natal chart, using the Sibley chart, the United States is a Sagittarius rising. I mean, yeah, Sagittarius rising, 12 degrees Sagittarius. And the seventh house of the United States is the opposite sign, Gemini, right? And in that case, this puts the Supreme Court ruling decision, right, in the sign of Taurus, which is the sixth house of the USA. And that is often the house to do with the working people, the everyday people, you know, the economy of wages and workers and industry. And I'm just curious about how this decision will impact the collective movement of everyday people around a decision that may not be favored by a lot of people, even those who do not agree with abortion do agree with the right to choose for each woman. So just thinking, I'm not too sure how that'll work out. I know I'm going to be missing a lot of details. This is not meant to be a super in-depth, you know, thing. It's just a little broadcast about what I'm seeing. So I was taking a gander at the chart of the solstice set for Washington, D.C., and I'll pull that up. And the summer solstice chart is a story of what happens in a certain place between, you know, events like this is a summer solstice on the 21st of the month of June, which goes till the fall equinox, which will be around the 23rd of September. And in the sky, set for Washington, D.C., at the exact moment the sun goes into zero, ingresses 0 degrees of Cancer. This is a sky that tells us a couple of things for the Washington area, which of course includes the Supreme Court and the United States government's central capital, things that influence the policy of the USA. This is a chart in which there is a reversal of the United States, Sagittarius, ascendant, descendant. So basically now the US is sort of cast with a Gemini of two minds, the twins, two things, you know, and energetic identity. All right. And also more importantly, this descendant is at 21 degrees and 57 minutes, really 22 degrees of Sagittarius. There's a star called the Shaula. It's a stinger in the tail of the scorpion. And we actually had a moon that hit that same position just back in June 14th. So this is like not a completely new story. That full moon was also on Shaula the stinger on 21 degrees or so of 22.3 of Sagittarius. So the stinger is what is coming through in the United States. It's going to feel like a scorpion sting, basically, especially given the descendant is kind of indicative of oppositional energy to something. Like there's, you know, on the other side of the US is temporary bifurcated fickle twins identity. And think about the lack of partisanship cooperation. Think about the fact that there is a complete polarity in the partisan politics of the United States and the stinger that results from that. And that stinger, ouch, you know, is connecting to women, and women are often connected to the moon. And you see the moon in the solstice chart for the USA, Washington, D.C., conjunct Jupiter, the god of justice and legal affairs and courts, and the wounded healer Chiron is over here as well. So you can see there's some kind of woundedness around a justice situation that could show up anytime between June 21st and September of 2023. There is a possibility you're going to see a lot of demonstrations, because when I see Mars in Aries in the 11th house, I think of hordes of people marching on Capitol Hill. This looks to me like protests, and it looks like vigorous protests, because Jupiter blows those protests up. So this is just the beginning of what's going to be a very gnarly summer in the US, because I don't think this is going to lie down quickly. I think there's going to be a huge amount of resentment and difficulty with what happens as a result of this. It's almost like the United States is approaching, in its Pluto return, some kind of civil war. It may not be the old style with guns and stuff like that, fighting each other, but rather there are such different sensibilities between the rural conservative South and the coastal urban liberal / Democrat sensibilities. There's just two different worlds polarizing ever more extremely. To be clear, I'm a centrist. And when I look at the polarity divide in both the Democratic and Republican, and I'm Canadian, by the way, energies, I like think they're both off the rails, honestly. I mean, there's some of the woke liberal culture that really drives me nuts. It's like over the top. So, and on the other hand, of course, when one side goes to one extreme, the other side goes to the other extreme. And so that's what we're seeing in the world. And we're certainly seeing it in Canada. And it's also happening in the United States. And anything else I want to say? Well, this is kind of portentous of the Supreme Court decision too, because even though we already got a leaked document that there would be this release of this likely verdict on the Supreme Court ruminations, you know, the day that it was announced, right, it was a Taurus in the House of Courts. And here you can see the backroom dealings, right? This is like backroom negotiations, what was going on, and, you know, already on the 21st of June in the back rooms of power around this decision that was going to be announced, and when they were going to choose to announce it. I don't know if there's anything else I can say about that other than astrology does show us what is likely to happen in the sky, maybe why it's likely to happen, and gives us a heads up about it. But I do have some deep philosophy about astrology lately that I'm working with as an astrologer, because the whole free will and fate thing is a big conundrum for me. And I see the sky as telling me what's happening, but the prime mover of reality is not where I think it is or where you think it is. And this is a part of my thing going on here. I had a couple spiritual awakenings in my life and it's almost like we're watching events unfold in a video that's got a beginning, middle, and end. And just if you were watching a movie on a TV screen, you wouldn't be thinking about how you were going to either fast forward to see what was going to happen and then change it, or reverse the video and change it. We just know we're watching a show. And sometimes I feel that we're watching a show called reality. Okay, so I'm going to go back outside. It's gorgeous and sunny here. I was just out on the beach getting sunburned in Vancouver, Canada. I hope you guys are doing okay. I'll pop this right up onto YouTube ASAP. On June 24th at 5:30 Pacific when I'm recording it. So if you want to ruminate about it, you can as well.